serious enough to mention, the official said. Only 18 people survived the August 20th takeoff crash on a flight from Madrid to the Canary Islands. The plane struggled to get airborne, hit the ground tail first, skidded and bounced three times over more than a kilometer before disintegrating and burning. This now according to the head of the Spanish commission investigating the crash. That gentleman said that it was too early to establish the cause of the crash, but a preliminary report should be out in a month. Insurance Day is reporting that increased awareness of the threat of earthquakes is being credited for a record rise in the number of Japanese policyholders buying earthquake coverage. Last year saw a 44% increase in the number of fire insurance policyholders also taking out protection against earthquakes, according to figures coming from the Non-Life Insurance Rating Organization of Japan. In an article appearing today written by Richard Banks, the numbers came out as authorities in China discussed including fundamental principles on catastrophe insurance in a draft revamp of insurance rules that would also extend the scope of China's insurers to protect their own investments. In Japan, of course, the number of powerful earthquakes last year, including one in Ishikawa Prefecture in March of 2007, is thought to have raised public awareness of disaster insurance. Indeed, as Mr. Banks points out, Ishikawa was the prefecture showing the largest increase in earthquake policies being purchased. Yesterday, if you were flying in the United States, you already know this. Massive flight delays caused by an electronic communication failure at an FAA facility drew new criticism for an agency that has been scrutinized over air traffic controller staffing levels and inspection standards for its ground-based equipment. The Northeast U.S. was hardest hit by the delays prompted yesterday by a glitch at a Hampton, Georgia facility that processes flight plans for the eastern half of the United States. By early evening yesterday, the FAA said that the situation around the country was returning to normals. Delays only remained at Atlanta and Chicago. At one point, the FAA said that airport delays at some 36 major airports across the country were in full swing. The FAA said that the glitch appeared to have involved a software problem. A spokesperson said that there were no safety issues and that officials were still able to speak to pilots on planes. The officials said that they did not know exactly how many flights were affected, but she said that it was in the hundreds. The FAA did not expect to have total figures out until this afternoon. In a 24-hour period, though, the FAA processes more than 300,000 flight plans in the U.S. The problem that occurred yesterday involved a failure in a communication link that transmits flight plan data from the Georgia facility to a similar facility in Salt Lake City, Utah. As a result, the Salt Lake facility was having to process all of those flight plans, causing delays in planes taking off. The consulting firm Ernst & Young has come out with a study saying that reinsurers believe that depending on the quality of underwriting data insurers submit to them, they could be giving the carrier a credit or hitting them with a surcharge. Quality of critical data can include the number and location of buildings owned by an organization or the number of retail outlets, said E&Y. Missing data was brought to the forefront after Hurricane Katrina, when losses originally projected at $20 to $40 billion actually came in at about $60 billion. According to the E&Y 2008 Catastrophe Exposure Data Quality Survey, raising the bar on cat exposure data quality when it comes to their ability to underwrite property cat exposure, the biggest concern among reinsurers is the quality of cedents' data. In fact, primary insurers may not be aware that they could be paying more for reinsurance because of missing information. About 90% of reinsurers say that they apply surcharges to compensate for data quality deficiencies. Among these, 70% said that they would include a 25% premium. This is unbelievable. About 70% that they would include a 25% premium penalty. What's more, about 92% of reinsurers said confidence that the cedent had said confidence that the cedent did not use strong controls when collecting data could mean premium credits between 5% and 15%. More than one-third said that they'd be willing to offer a minimum 10% premium credit for cedents with high-quality data. One reason, according to the study, that reinsurers apply surcharges rather than going back to fill in the data is that, quote, reinsurers renew a lot of contracts at the same time, during January 1 renewals, for example. The study said they have a lot to do at once and may not go through the smaller accounts as thoroughly as possible. When analyzing the potential risk of a cedent with poor data quality, 58% of reinsurers say that they directly modify their catastrophe model results, while the remaining 42% make upward adjustments to the data before running their models. If these cedents had pivot point systems, they would not be making these kinds of mistakes. There's a lot of money left on the table here. A story in the New York Times this morning is saying that after climbing steadily for 6 years, the number of Americans without health insurance dropped by more than 1 million last year, down to 45.7 million. This story comes as a result of statistics released by the U.S. Census Bureau. The number of people covered by private insurance declined in 07, but that was offset by government programs. The drop was the result of growth in government-sponsored health insurance programs, officials said, most of them focused on children. At the same time, the number of people covered by private insurance continued to decline. Experts cautioned that the report, which also included data on income and poverty, did not yet take into account the economic downturn that began late last year, and therefore it probably presents a rosier picture than the current economic reality. The rate of people without health insurance declined to 15.3% in 2007. From 15.8% a year earlier. Sears Holdings voluntarily recalled 145,000 Kenmore brand coffee makers because the wiring can overheat and cause fires or burns. This according to the U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission yesterday. The recall includes 12-cup Kenmore and Kenmore Elite coffee makers sold at Sears and Kmart stores. The company and the CPSC said that there have been 20 reports of coffee makers overheating, including 12 fires, and these fires have caused damage to countertops, cabinets, and floors. No injuries have been reported. The retailer advised consumers to stop using the coffee makers and return them to Sears or Kmart stores for a free replacement. We've got some civil strife going on in Southeast Asia, and it's not the usual place, Myanmar. This time it's in Thailand. Thousands of anti-government protesters blockaded the Prime Minister's office this morning, and their leaders challenged the police to enter and arrest them. Following a clash between protesters and the police earlier in the day that left several people injured, nearly 2,000 police officers with helmets and riot shields pressed in and around the demonstrators who were inside the Prime Minister's gated compound but had not entered the main building. Police said that a court had issued warrants for the arrests of 9 of the protest leaders. The raid by protesters on the Prime Minister's office began building yesterday, were part of what protesters called a, quote, final push after 3 months of demonstrations aimed at unseating the government of Prime Minister Samak Sundarrajev. This government needs to resign, said one of the protesters. Sorry state of affairs. Thailand is a country that's very stable. And we'll, of course, keep watching that because there's an awful lot of Western investment there. Stock market remains about where it was. It's up about 48 points. If we have any breaking news, we'll come back and tell you. If not, we'll see you tomorrow.